super generous words. I am very honored and very humbled to be here tonight, to be part of this very, very distinguished group of people, the past honorees. It's kind of an amazing thing because it comes in a time of my life that I realize that I've been teaching for more than 30 years, you know, which means lots and lots of kids from different places, and not just teaching at my university here in the United States, but also in Brazil. And now, because of the power of technology, I actually can teach directly. I have a YouTube channel, only in Portuguese, where I have live chats almost every week. And it's really amazing to see, you know, that you have 8-year-old kids and 80-year-old gentlemen and ladies asking me questions about black holes and about the meaning of life and are we going to survive artificial intelligence and all that stuff. And it's sort of because, in a sense, you're cutting the middleman. You're going straight to what people care about. And what people care about is the deep questions of existence and their relationship with a very scientific society, right? So I'm really, really very happy to be here. And where is Luan? Luan, you started all this. So Luan Zurlo, she's the one that really deserves the applause here. She's a wonderful human being. And she, being a Dartmouth alumna, she invited me to be part of this. But why me? You know, I mean, I was not part of it. I was the only professor in the whole council. It was very interesting that there was one board member that was actually teaching, and Hélène, of course, Racias. And I understood, you know, in one sense, they were very smart because they realized that if you convince this guy of what we're doing and the value of what we're doing, then he can be a very strong ally because he will go straight to the teachers of Brazil and talk to them about the importance of teaching. Because one thing that I have learned, you know, in my years as a teacher is that no teacher in the world, it doesn't matter how good you are, can teach a kid that doesn't want to learn. I mean, you can be the best teacher, but if the interest is not there, it's just not going to happen. So the real good teacher is the teacher that not only conveys information, but is the teacher that actually creates this urge to know. That this understanding that to know something, to learn something, is a way in which I transform myself and I transform the life that I can have. And I realized that, wow, these guys, you know, Americans figuring out that we need this in Brazil big time, you know, because in the public school system of Brazil, you know, which is vast, huge, there is very little resources to train the teachers and certainly to equip laboratories. So how on earth are you going to teach sciences and mathematics to kids if you, first of all, you don't know the subject or you don't have passion for teaching that subject, and if you don't have the tools to make them experiment? Because one thing that is true about science is that you learn by doing. You know, you have to do to learn. You can't read about stuff in books and think you're learning stuff. You have to really get your hands dirty and do it, which actually was beautifully illustrated in the video here. You saw all the little machines and the kids all over it, because that's how you do it, because there is something very playful about learning and about learning sciences also. Although I'm sure that all of you, or most of you, said, really? You know, I mean, science can be fun. When? Where? Well, it can if it's done the right way. And one of the things that the Educando platform is doing is teaching the teachers to do it the right way, to create something of an enchantment for science, for nature. And this word enchantment is really important because it colors, it changes the way a student relates to what's being taught. And the student understands that, oh, this is not just about memorizing the names of animals or the parts of a cell or the equations of geometry. This is about how the world works and how we fit in that world. And that is just beautiful. And I have seen with my own eyes that when I gave lectures to teachers in the STEM program in Brazil, they felt so validated. Because, you know, nobody's thinking about these guys in general, you know? It is really hard to be a public teacher, in a public school teacher in South America, in Latin America. It is, I consider these people mostly heroes, to be honest with you, because they are severely underpaid, undertrained, have a huge teaching load, and don't have the equipment that they need to do their jobs. So here comes Educando and boom, you know, teaches them, tells them that they make a difference, tells them that they inspire the future generation of people so that one day, as you have seen Consuelo here tonight, they become the teachers and the innovators and the inspirers for the next generation. And that is transformation. And I got this and I was like, yep, Educando is wonderful. And I'm very proud to have served in the board. And one of the other things that I wanted to say, and I wanted to say it starts with a cliche, which is everybody here knows that life is a journey. The thing that is not a cliche on this story is that a lot of the parts of that journey you don't choose. You are born in a certain family, you are born in a certain country or in a certain part of a country, and a lot of people do not share the luck that a lot of us have, you know. So yes, I am from Rio, I'm from Brazil, and here I am now, you know, on top of Columbus Circle giving a talk, which is really kind of amazing for a boy that grew up in Copacabana. But I was not the kid from the slums. You know, I was the kid from a very well-educated, top middle-class family. And that makes a huge difference because the educational system in Brazil and in most of Latin America is upside down. What happens is this, as you probably all know, the universities are free, or the public universities are free, but they have a limited amount of spaces. So in order to get to the public university, you have to pass an exam, which is a huge bottleneck. And to get to pass the exam, you have to go to what? The private schools. They have the resources to teach the students to be able to go through, you know, and get into the schools. The public school students cannot compete. And that is ironic. And that needs to be changed. And that is the work that I think is going on here. Because you can, if you train the public school teachers and you equip the schools properly, you can actually make them competitive with the private schools. And then those kids that didn't have the luck that I had will actually have a chance to create a life where they control a big part of their journey and not just a little one. So thank you again. I'm very proud to be here tonight.